What's up, everybody? It's your boy, The Trill Collector, coming to you guys with another figure review. I want to say, before we get started, guys, I want to say thank you, man, to all my new subscribers, man. I want to say thank you, man, to all the individuals checking out old videos and posting comments and likes, man. That really means a lot. I know I haven't been putting out content like I should, man, but, you know, with family and jobs, man, you got to kind of find that balance to try to, you know, make great content for you guys and bring these awesome figure reviews to you guys that you guys look forward to all the time. So with that being said, guys, we're going to go ahead and kick it off, man, with one of my favorite last prize figures, man, from one of my favorite Coogee lotteries that came out about 2 years ago, came out in 2019. And what we'll be looking at today, guys, is the Greatest Saiyan Gold Ozaru Goku from Dragon Ball GT, man. Before we get into it, guys, I'm gonna show you a little bit of the box art here. Side art, the back, which I think is absolutely phenomenal, man. Some of the best artwork I've seen on the back of a box in a very, very long time. And as always, Toei Animation Stick of Authenticity to show you that it's real and not a fake. So, little background about this figure. Like I stated earlier, guys, this is the last prize from the greatest Saiyan Kuji that came out in 2019. That particular Kuji, the main figure lots, the Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta, Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, Super Saiyan 4 Goku, and the Gold Ozaru here. All these figures are based off of the Dragon Ball GT anime, the manga, you know. So I thought that that was really awesome because that's one of my favorite series. And when I saw these figures, man, I definitely had to grab them. This figure here, actually, and the reason I'm going over here, guys, because the figure's already out of the box already. So, you know, don't mind me. I'm just, you know, trying to get some things situated right now. But this figure here, man, this is great. I keep wanting to say Extreme Saiyan. That's not true. This is the Greatest Saiyan. This was the actual first prize that I ever owned. And to be completely honest, the other three figures in the lot were the first figures that I ever had to my collection. Now, with that being said, this is not the original. This is one that I bought from a good friend of mine in my Facebook group, man, Mr. Jorge Robles. Really awesome guy, man. Really gave me this figure for a steal. So shout out to you, man. So if you guys are on Facebook and you guys looking for an awesome group of people to hang out with, man, to just chat with about anime, all type of things, looking for certain figures, man, head over to Facebook and go ahead and check out Smash Collecting. It's an awesome group of individuals over there, man. Lots of knowledge combined between all of us. Also, we individuals can get figures, man, that's pretty much hard to get. They can get anything, pretty much anything that you guys are looking for. They have the connections over there to pretty much get what you want. So that's a little backdrop about where this figure came from, the Kuji that he was part of. And before we get into it, you know, I just want to, you know, just tell you guys that this figure has gone up in price. When I say tremendously, I mean tremendously, guys. This figure, when I first bought it, I think it was $89. And that was back in 2019 at a comic book shop here in Houston, Texas called Bedrock City. I mean, man, this figure here, man, I mean, once you saw it in the shop, it commanded, you know, presence and demanded attention, because look at this packaging. You know what I'm saying? I mean, if you could see this huge box, you know, on a end cap or something, or maybe on top of a display or something, this thing really, you know, when you saw it, it drew your attention to it. And this was one of the ones that I had to have, solely because it's Dragon Ball GT, and because at that time I never saw an Ozaru figure ever, you know. And I know they've been out for a while, you know, but I've never saw one at that time, you know. So I definitely had to grab this guy. But like I said, this guy here, man, has gone up in price. You can't find this guy for $89 anymore unless it's like a bootleg or something. Now I think the cheapest that I've seen this guy go for, Oh man, private sellers. I've seen them ask for maybe $220. I've seen on Amazon $250. I've seen eBay people ask for $375, $400. When I've looked at eBay and saw what they sold for, I seen the highest one I seen sell for was $360, man. And that was in May of this past year. $360, going up from, you know, $89 from 2 years ago. So that shows you how sought after this bad boy is, and just how much prices increase on these LPs, man. I mean, these things, I mean, once you get your hand on one, man, you pretty much hold on to them, because certain ones, certain characters, in my opinion, they hold value more. They're really sought after because you really don't know if they're gonna make another one or if they're ever gonna come out with another variant of that specific character. So like with this guy right here, I don't think we'll ever get another Golden Grade 8. That's just me, solely because there was only one, and that was that we seen in the series, and that was Goku before he turned Super Saiyan 4. Now we do have the Vegeta, which I don't think we'll have another one of those again. We have the Great Ozaru, which I think is the either Goku or Gohan. I'm not sure, but you know, it says Great Ozaru on the box and it says Dragon Ball, so I take it that it's Goku. And then we have the you know, you have like the ultra rare things like the Zeme Ozaru versus Goku, and then you have the Kuji Ozaru Vegeta versus Goku, and from my knowledge, that's the only ones that I've known that are Kujis. So with that being said, guys, that's a little bit of the pricing and background this bad boy here. So now we're going to get into why you guys are really here, and this is to take a look at this beast right here, man. One of my favorite figures, man. I've downsized my collection, not a lot, but mainly I'm after Ozaru's now, man. My Manga Dimensions collection has really, you know, built back up from where it was a long time ago. And so, you know, this is one of my favorites. You know, it holds a sentimental place in my heart, man, because this was the first figure, the first LP that I had before I knew what an LP was. So, getting into it, man, you can look at the awesome detail on this guy here, man. This guy stands roughly about 13 inches tall. Going from the top of his fist down to his feet here. He does come in two pieces. He comes with the solid body here, as you guys can see. And then his tail detaches here. And then he also comes with the stand, which I don't display because he's perfectly balanced. Now, with that being said, this guy here, if you're going to have him displayed, okay, have him on top of a cabinet or something, or if you have one of those, I call them like comic book store type detox that have like the big open doors that you can like, you know, put huge figures in, like resin statues and all that type of stuff. That's the kind of display you need to put this bad boy in, because my detox cabinets that I have here behind me, like these guys here, he will not fit in there. And I tried to put him in there, man, because like I said, he's one of my personal grails, so I want to, you know, have him with my other personal grails that I have in my collection. But you know, just for sheer size, man, he won't fit in there. Now getting into some of the aspects of him as far as detail on the body, I really like how you have the gold, the yellow contrast with a little bit of orange like you see here in the abs and all of that. I think that's pretty awesome. And then also on the side here, contrast is really, really well on the back as well. You know, I think that's pretty awesome, man. And then look, you can see his face sculpt, you know, his portrait, you know, pretty much typical Ozaru, man. Fierce, unrelenting, man. I mean, he's just a beast, man. And that's what an Ozaru is all about, man. Just uncontrollable rage, power, and all of that, you know. And I feel like Kuji at that time really, they really captured the essence of that particular character in that scene from Dragon Ball GT, man. Now, with this being said, out of all the Ozarus that I own, the Goku versus Vegeta Ozaru versus Goku, the Great Ozaru, Ozaru Vegeta, and this guy right here, Ozaru Vegeta and Golden Ozaru are the most detailed in my opinion. And the reason that I say that is because these are newer Kujis. So of course, you know, over time, once you get, you know, a little bit more fond of, you know, putting out more quality product. I'm not saying that they didn't put out product, but compared to the older stuff, these guys blow them out of the water. So, you know, highly detailed figure, man. One of my favorites, sorry to sound repetitive. This guy really pairs well with the Ozaru Vegeta. And another thing that's really awesome about this too, man, is that this particular Kuji set, in my opinion, the greatest Saiyan, has the best sculpt of Super Saiyan 4 Goku and Vegeta that you could possibly, in my opinion, that you could possibly get your hands on. Every figure in that lot has jumped, has skyrocketed in price, man. I remember when I bought mine, man, I got them for like maybe $35 each. Probably, I think Gogeta was maybe the highest. He was like $45 maybe. But now, you know, you have the Goku and Vegeta alone is like $100 now, you know, and the Gogeta is probably like around $100 as well. So this whole lot now, if you count him, you're looking at maybe you could probably get $400. No, you probably get a little bit more than that because this guy's going for like $220 alone. So you're looking at probably about $620, man, for the entire set, you know, versus when it came out, you could have got the entire set for under $200, you know. But that just goes to show that when people really go after them and they see their value and they're kind of hard to get on the market, you know, these things, they really jump up, man. So, you know, with that being said, guys, man, this is the Golden Ozaru Goku, man, from the Greatest Saiyan line, the LP. One of my favorite figures in my entire collection, man. So happy to have this bad boy back home, man, and just, you know, have him amongst my other personal grails of mine. Another thing too, guys, if you guys are looking for one, like I stated previously, earlier in the video, man, you can check eBay, you can check personal sellers if you guys have them. If you guys are in a Facebook group, if you guys are on Facebook, should I say, I urge you guys to head over there, man, and check out Smash Collecting. I know definitely there's individuals over there, man, that can get you this guy with no problem, especially our friends that are over there in Japan, man, that's in the service, you know, and, you know, helping us out over there, man. So you can definitely, you know, hit those guys up, man, and they can pretty much get it. Now, with that being said, the price on this bad boy is what you have to look at, okay? Like I said, can't find him anywhere for $89 unless you're going for like maybe a bootleg or something. But, you know, expect to come out of pocket, you know, maybe on the low end, maybe $180, high end, almost like $300, you know. And when I say the low end, that's rare to find one for $180 now. The price range that I'm seeing that I monitor now on this particular figure is anywhere from $220 to maybe $260. So between that $220 and $260 is where this guy is gonna be at, you know, and maybe capping off for over $260, like maybe $270 or whatever. So, you know, with that being said, guys, man, if you guys are interested in getting the man, head over to Facebook, check out Smash Collecting, or you can go on eBay. Amazon might have them. But the thing about Amazon, man, is that I'm really not sure if it's a legit figure. So that's one thing that you really have to, you know, have to be leery of, is that, you know, because it comes from Amazon or it comes from another place, man, like over here, it really does not mean that it's like the legit thing. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to discredit them or anything, but that's how I deal with individuals in my group only when it comes to certain figures, man. Because I know the legitimacy of what they have. And I also know, with being fellow collectors, that they keep the same mentality that I have when it comes to certain figures, man. When it comes to figures in general, you want the real thing. You don't want anything fake or anything, because that kind of throws your whole collection off. And that's, you know, that's not, you know, what this is about, you know, unless you're, you know, into like customizing and all that type of stuff and, you know, doing all that, which I think is really awesome. But as far as that, if you're just an average collector like myself, man, and you want the real thing, then those are the individuals that I deal with. So with that being said, guys, as always, man, this is the Trill Collector. If you guys are on Instagram, man, head over there to Instagram, man, and check out my page. It's Trill_Collector512. There, man, I post photos. I post all my new figures, man, that I get, you know, as time progresses, man. I get stuff all the time. So you guys can see that over there, man. We can interact there. We can interact here on YouTube, man, and all of that. So be on the lookout, guys, man. I have two of my favorite figures, man, that's coming in right now from the new Kuji, from the new EX Kuji that came out this past month. I have the Vegeta, base form Vegeta, which I think is really, really awesome, man. He should be here no later than today. And then I have the Kaioken Times 3 Goku, which I'm really, really looking forward to, man. Those two are two of the three that I really want. I want the Nappa as well, but I haven't really had luck tracking him down yet. But he's definitely on the way as well. So be on the lookout for that, guys. Hopefully tomorrow I'll have that Vegeta review up for you guys, man. We can check it out together. So as always, guys, the Trill Collector. And as always, man, keep it trill and keep collecting. Until next time. Bye.